I'm an economist based at the School of Population Health at UWA. I currently teach health economics at the undergraduate and postgraduate levels, and that is a bit challenging. Firstly, because these units are core units in their respective degree programs. Second, economics can be a very dense subject area. And third, because these are core units, the students normally have no general interest in this area at all.
So actually, before I started health economics, I think it was the most daunting subject for me. I have no background in economics at all or business, and so I thought this was going to be the most difficult course I'd be taking.
So the way that I actually overcome these challenges is by using magic in my teaching, which I find sparks students' interest and also make it easier to learn and remember concepts.
Health economics as a unit is pretty tricky, but I think the way he engages us and the way he kind of uses magic is really interesting and helps make the unit so much more enjoyable. And I think when students enjoy the unit, then they do better.
Srishti, look at the card. All right, do you want to show it to all your friends? Okay, now basically, I will lose your card in the deck. Pretty easy, but what magicians do is that we are just tricking you. We have actually managed to control your card up to the top of the deck again. What is your card?
Five of hearts.
Five of hearts, and it comes right up to the top. Five of hearts or four of hearts?
Five.
You sure?
Yes.
Well, that's okay. I'm going to take the four of hearts and just put it over here. So you sure it's the five of hearts?
Yes.
In that case, what we are really missing is just a heart, aren't we? Perfect. So take the three of hearts. All right, that was the three of hearts. Take off the heart. And paste it on the four parts and then mix it the five parts. That's what we call a heart transplant.
For me, the best thing about Ian's teaching is he takes difficult concepts and makes it a lot easier for students to understand, and he uses really creative methods of doing that.
Ian's really funny and he's really engaging. He doesn't just kind of stand there and talk against the slide. He kind of engages all of us and talks to all of us, and he really understands his work and what he's teaching, so it helps us to understand it better as well.
Magic is really useful for teaching for three reasons. One, it is an excellent icebreaker and builds up rapport really easily. Two, everyone has interest in magic, and so everyone loves and enjoys watching me perform. And three, magic really is very memorable and helps remember concepts, and students often tell me that they find it a really effective way of learning. All right. How long do you think it's going to take for me to find your card and sort out the deck?
5 minutes.
5 minutes? There are some that's face up, some that's face down, and some that's back to back. Everything has now turned itself back to the correct order except for one card.
So Ian uses a lot of magic in his teaching, which is so refreshing and really creative. You don't see many lecturers who are able to do magic. And so that's a really great way to get your head around difficult concepts and to sort of visualize it. And for me, it's really helped me remember these things throughout my course.
The magic tricks, they weren't just for entertainment. They were obviously for relaying the concepts as well. And I found them really, really effective, because taking on concepts sometimes can be quite tricky, but being engaged by the magic tricks, the entertainment, it allowed me to take it in and enjoy it and actually listen to what was being said. So I guess it just accelerated my learning as well.
Does anyone have $20? Thank you. Now again, as I've shown you guys before, every time I fold, it is a time period. All right, so that's one, that's two, and that's five. The impact of time periods that has passed has actually caused the money to be worth less than it was 5 time periods ago. Okay, so your $10 5 time periods ago is now only worth $5. I'm a hobbyist magician. Magic is a way of making the illogical appear logical, and I think that's what we all do as teachers.
The magic tricks were effective because they kept us really well engaged, and they, you know, obviously, like, you want to capture some emotion in your students, and that's what he managed to do.
Ian's method of teaching is effective because when he uses magic, we all remember the concepts that he was talking about really well. When he does a magic trick right after teaching us a concept, we tend to remember the whole thing together and remember that whole experience.
He likes to take it down to a personal level in terms of teaching, so he'll make sure he'll come around every desk and ask every single person, oh, how are you coping with this? Do you understand? And at first we thought, oh, that's so time consuming, like, cheat's gonna take forever to finish, but we found it really helpful at the end because we really understood what was needed to be learned for that topic.
So the lectures and tutorials are incredibly interactive. Yeah.
This trick is basically about teaching the power of information asymmetry when two parties have got different amount of knowledge about what's going on. The game simply involves you guessing where paper ball is. Okay, I'm going to always do it 1, 2, 3, and then you just have to guess whether it's in the left or right hand. Simple game.
Right hand.
Right hand. No.